Hi folks, welcome back to the Dashcam Dasher once again. So, it has been a long time since I have made a video with my car. So, getting into the video today, what I believe is, owning a car is not just knowing how to drive it, but also to know the basic maintenance and repairs, like replacing a flat tire, and also checking the oil level of the engine, etc. So, these things are not rocket science, but can come in handy in emergency situations. One such basic thing is, knowing where the fuse box in your car is and knowing how to replace these things. So this is a 2017 first generation Hyundai Creta. This car has two fuse boxes, one inside the engine compartment just near the battery and another fuse box just below the headlight height adjustment switch inside the cabin near the driver.
So this is the fuse box present in the engine compartment just next to the battery. To remove the cover, there are two locks given. Just push the lock and lift the cover. The cover will easily come off. So these are the fuses present inside this fuse box. It contains all the fuses related to the functioning of the engine, including fuel pump, spark plugs, radiator fan, etc. The power rating of each fuse is mentioned in the top of the fuse itself. So the more the power, the bigger the fuse is. The box also has some empty slots. Maybe those empty slots are meant for the diesel engine. So this is the fuse box cover. And on the inside, they have given a detailed diagram which mentions the function of each and every fuse present in the fuse box. Also, they have given 5 spare fuses in the fuse box cover. Just in case, if any fuse goes off, we can replace them with the ones given here. Also, they have given a fuse puller for the ease of replacing these fuses. Actually, I lost my fuse puller. It accidentally fell into the engine compartment while I was trying to remove a fuse. So I purchased an extra fuse puller, but it didn't fit into this cover. So I have kept it in my glove box, which I will show later in the video. So, for closing the fuse box, just keep the cover over the fuse box and just give a press. The locks will get into place and then it's over. So, this is the fuse box present inside the engine cabin. There is a slot, just put your finger and pull it, it will come off. So this is the fuse box. There is also an on and off switch. Also, your OBD cable port is also present in this fuse box. Also, we can see some empty slots in the fuse box. Actually, the export variant of this vehicle has some extra features, and those fuses are meant for those particular features. This fuse box holds all the fuses related to the electronics present inside the cabin, including the two power outlets, the in-cabin lighting, etc. Here also, we can find a detailed fuse box diagram on the inside of the cover. So from the diagram, we can clearly understand this fuse box holds the fuse for the airbags, the power steering, and even the brake switch. Now, let us see how to replace a fuse using the fuse puller. So this is the fuse puller. Just hold the fuse with the puller and then pull it back. It needs some effort and the fuse cannot be removed with your fingers. So here we can clearly see the fuse is in good condition. So for putting the fuse back, just keep it in the slot and give it a small press and the fuse will settle in place. Then you can remove the fuse puller. So for putting back the cover, you can see two locks here given at the cover and there is two corresponding slots provided. Just put the lock in those slots and just press the cover and it will set in place. So before finishing, let me tell you something. In 2 weeks time, the curtains will go up and my new ride will be revealed. Stay tuned, guys. Thanks for watching.